Everyone, this is Edunic. Today I am going to provide a short video tutorial on how to use mesh analysis to solve for circuit parameters. Mesh analysis, before going into the tutorial, we need to understand this base. The base mesh analysis is Kirchhoff's voltage law or KVL. Kirchhoff's voltage law states that the algebraic sum of voltages in a branch of each branch in a closed path in a circuit is zero. That is, algebraic sum of voltage drops in a loop is zero. So we just have to add the voltage drops across each element in a closed loop and equate it to zero. So let's understand mesh analysis with a simple problem. Let me consider a circuit like this. 5 ohm, 10 ohm, and 50 volts. Here let it be 2 ohm. Now, there are three basic steps for solving this circuit. Let the question be, find the voltage drop across 5 ohm resistor. Okay, so step 1, we assign direction for loop currents. We just have to assign arbitrary directions. In my case, I always take clockwise directions for current, like this, I1 and I2. Just take it for all loops, clockwise direction you take, so that we don't have much confusion. If the current is in opposite direction, we ultimately get a negative sign in the answer, so we can know it's in the opposite direction. Now step 2, based on this direction of current, we assign polarity for elements. In this case, here the resistor, the current is entering like this and leaving like this. So we put a positive sign at the entering side and negative sign at the leaving side, like this for 10 ohm. And for batteries, we know that this is positive and this is negative, so we assign that also. In the case of this 2 ohm resistor, which is common to both the loops, we let it just let it be like that. We understand when we write the equation. Now step 3, we write the mesh equations. This is the final step. So we consider loop 1. Actually, we are applying KVL in loop 1. So we start from a point in the loop and we have to end at that exact point. In my case, I take this point in loop 1 and this point in loop 2 and complete it like this. So in loop 1, I first encounter the plus sign. So 5, I want the voltage drop across this, according to Ohm's law, is V equal to I into R. That is 5 into I1. That's what I wrote here. Now, moving on to the 2 ohm resistor. Yeah, when considering 2 ohm resistor, assign it as plus and write I1 minus I2. When we consider the first loop, we give importance to I1 and not I2. So we take I1 as the greater value and write I1 minus I2. This is all just an assumption. We get answer as negative or positive according to our assumption, right or wrong. That's not an issue. Now we move on to the 10 volt battery and we get minus 10 equal to 0. Solving, we get 7 I1 minus 2 I2 equal to 10. This is our first loop equation or mesh equation. Now loop 2, similarly we write the equation 10 I2 plus 50. Here the positive sign is encountered first. If we encounter the positive sign first, put positive, otherwise put negative. Now plus 2 into I2 minus I1 equal to 0. Now if we solve for this equation, 2i1 plus 12i2 equal to minus 50. These are two equations in two variables which you can solve mathematically. You can either use a calculator or solve by some method. I solved it and I got the values as 0.25 amperes for I1 and I2 as minus 4.125 ampere. This minus sign indicates that I2 is actually in the opposite direction that we took, that is the anti-clockwise direction, and I1 is in this direction. Okay, so now we have to find the voltage drop across 5 ohm. Voltage drop across 5 ohm is I1 into 5, which is equal to 0.25 into 5 is 1.25 volts. This is a question. So I'm doing a little more to make you further understand or solve big problems. If we have a voltage source like this, plus minus 5 V5 is the voltage drop across 5 ohm. We just have to add plus 5 V5 in this loop 2 equation, as this is plus, this is minus, which will be given in the question. Plus 5, so we get a plus 5 V5 here. V5, as we know, is 5 into I1, which we can substitute, and still we get equations in I1 and I2. Similarly, you can also solve for current sources. If we have a current source like here, we have a current source 0.1 ampere, let's say. So when we take I3 here, we know that I3 is flowing like here. So I3 is all we get directly as 0.1 ampere. The only difference we get is 10 into I2 minus I3, and I3's value is also given. So we get equations in I1 and I2 we can solve. So that's all in mesh analysis. I hope this was pretty clear, and you can practice with more problems, and this will prove as a very simple method for you as well.